Mathias Mpuuga, the leader of opposition, led a group of opposition legislators to Chigo Prison to check on the incarcerated legislators Alan Sewanyana of Machinje East, who is indisposed, and Muhammad Segirinya of Kawempe North. Although the delegation was given access to the prison, they were not allowed to see Sewanyana, who is sick. We learnt that the opposition was told that the legislator has decided not to entertain guests as he battles with sickness.
So we have not spoken to him, so it cannot be himself. We have not spoken to him. We have only spoken to one side. So one side claims that he has refused to be seen. So we've not heard from him. So if we had heard from him and it was his own refusal, we would have understood. But for you to come and tell me, like a little child, that he has refused, and I take that, is nonsense.
This shocked legislators wondering about the state of their colleague after discovering that he has been a regular visitor at Mulago Hospital and Makshon Bay Hospital recently.
Somebody you call sick, very ill, somebody you say cannot move, cannot sit, cannot eat, cannot do what, can decide on his own, can actually have their will to say, I'm not going to see my visitors. I think there must be something wrong that we have to work upon as leaders and as this government. They try to say he's well because the medical officer who came to explain to us saying he's okay, but at the end there, when I said that, oh, I miss him very much, I should have seen him, the medical doctor actually let herself away because then she said, oh, won't he be triggered? Meaning there's something specific about his mental state, his mental health, and they told us they've already recommended a psychologist and would like to know if he's okay, why then would a doctor recommend a psychologist?
However, the opposition was able to chat with Honorable Segirinya, who disclosed that Sewanyana is currently too weak to either walk or stand on his own without support. The leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, challenged the Commissioner General of Prisons, Dr. Johnson Byabashaija, to explain why they had not honored a court order requiring Honorable Alan Sewanyana to get specialized medical care.
Explanation given to us by the Honorable Segirinya could hold some water to the effect that the honorable member is unable to move, is physically incapable of moving on his own, that he has to be carried to from one destination to one place to another, and therefore we sense that the authorities fear to have this member carried the way he is supposed to be carried from one place to another, and therefore they prefer to have him kept away.
Mpuuga also scoffed at the Chief Justice Alphonse Owinyidolo over his promise for a speedy trial of the two MPs, saying that 1.5 years on remand without trial, the promise of a speedy trial does not make sense.
I want to advise the Honorable Chief Justice that the detention of these two members vacated all tenets of a free, fair and speedy trial. So there is no amount of speeding that he's going to talk about. Probably he's woken up after a long slumber to realize that the courts have been taken over. We want to invite him to take charge over the courts as Chief Justice. I don't know why he has to wake up last week to say they're going to go through a quick trial. 1.5 years on remand, denied bail. Does he want to share with us why judges were being changed? And eventually, we get a statement from Mr. Mseven to the effect that he's thankful of the judiciary for implementing his views on bail.
The two legislators have been in prison for 17 months without trial since they were arrested together in September 2021 and charged with 3 counts of murder and 1 of attempted murder in connection of the spate of killings that rocked Masaka in 2021. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.